There's a question here about what do Ahlul Sunnah say about the Ahad Hadith? Ahad Hadith. Before I go into answering this question, we need to understand where does the controversy arise in relation to the Ahad Hadith. By Ahad Hadith, what we mean, Ikhwan, is that when the reports from the Messenger Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam have come to us, sometimes they have come to us through many companions, 5, 6, 7, many companions who have seen something or heard something, then they transmitted that on to the next group of narrators. And in a like manner, it is continued up until it has reached us. This is what we call mutawatir, meaning it has been narrated by such a large number of people that it is impossible for it to be a lie or for them to have gathered together upon a lie. And anything which is other than this, then it is known as ahad. This is just a terminological usage used by some of the later scholars who came. So now what happened is, in the second century, when this poison and this filth of ilm al-kalam entered into the Muslims, and they began to deny Allah's names and Allah's attributes, and the narrations which mention Allah's attributes, those people who were upon this kalam, from the Jahmiyyah and the Mu'tazila, they were the most ignorant of people of the Sunnah of the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and they saw that the Sunnah clashed with their beliefs of trying to deny that Allah has names and attributes and actions. And so they tried to invent a principle by which they could argue with the people of Sunnah and Athar. And this principle was that anything which is mutawatir is qat'i, it is definitive knowledge, and anything which is other than that is dhanni, it is only speculative knowledge. It's not something that we can have aqidah in, because we would be sinful if we hold aqidah in that. And then from their jahl, from their ignorance, they began to use general verses in the Quran which speak of not following then, which they did not understand, and then they tried to argue for this position. So here, ya ikhwan, I'll bring to you a quote from Al-Khatib al-Baghdadi rahimahullah, who said in his book Al-Faqih wal-Mutafaqih, and he quotes the ijma', the consensus of all of the people of fiqh, of the people of jurisprudence, on this issue of accepting the ahad hadith. He says, brings his chain of narration, he says, لَا خِلَافَ بَيْنَ أَحْلِ الْفِقْهِ فِي قُبُولِ خَبْرِ الْآخَادِ إِذَا عُدِّلَتْ نَقَلَتُهُ وَسَلِمَ مِنَ النَّسْخِ حُكْمُهُ وَإِنْ كَانُوا مُتَنَازِئِينَ فِي شَرْطِ ذَلِكْ وَإِنَّمَا دَفَعَ خَبْرَ الْآهَادِ بَعْدُ أَحْلِ الْكَلَامِ لِعَجْزِهِ وَاللَّهُ أَعْلَمْ عَنْ عِلْمِ السُّنَنِ زَعَمَ أَنَّهُ لَا يَقْبَلُ مِنْهَا إِلَّا مَا تَوَاتِرَتْ بِهِ أَخْبَارُ مَنْ لَا يَجُوزُ عَلَيْهِ الْغَلَطُ وَالنِّسْيَانُ وَهَذَا عِنْدَنَا مِنْهُ ذَرِيئَةٌ إِلَىٰ إِبْتَالِ سُنَنِ الْمُصْطَفَىٰ. He says, there is no dispute between the people of the Ahlul Fiqh, the people of jurisprudence, regarding the acceptance of the Khabr al-Ahad, the hadith which has come through Ahad, when its narrators are trustworthy and when abrogation is not to be established in the case of that particular hadith. And then he says, continues, rather those who rejected the Khabr al-Ahad are some of the people of Kalam, meaning the Mu'tazila, and after them the Ash'ariyya and the Maturidiyya, due to their inability, because of their inability, Allah knows best, of having knowledge of the Sunnah. Why? Because they were ignorant of the Sunnah, because they did not take knowledge from the Sahaba and the Tabi'een. So they weren't familiar with the Sunnah of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Then he says, and he claims that it is not to be accepted from it, except that what is mutawatir. Then he continues at the end and he says, this in our view is a path and a means for rejection, for invalidating the Sunan of al-Mustafa, which is Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So do you understand what the purpose of this belief is, ya ikhwan? These people who were poisoned with kalam, they invented this false principle in order to debate and argue against the imams of the Sunnah to justify their falsehood. And what do we see in the 20th century? In the book of An-Nabahani, Ad-Dawsiyya, page number 6 and 7, this book Ad-Dawsiyya is something which is a secretive book. These people, they conceal some of their books, it's outside of the public view. In fact, it took us maybe 17 years to grab hold of a copy of this book. This is how secret they keep this book. And alhamdulillah, one of the brothers who sent me a copy or a scan of some of these pages, and he managed to get it from a former member of Hizb al-Tahrir who was very reluctant in giving it away. So in this book, Ad-Dawsiyya, this is page number 6 and 7, or page 7 and 8, sorry. And in this book, basically, I don't want to go through all the details. Essentially, what he's saying is that the mutawatir, the belief in the punishment of the grave, is it is haram to have i'tiqad. To have i'tiqad in the punishment of the grave, and anything else which is similar, which is mentioned in the Ahad Hadith. And he established, he builds it upon this principle of the Mu'tazila and those who are the enemies of the Sunnah, who wanted to invalidate the Sunnah. So he has about half a page in which he elaborates upon this very principle. And so, ya ikhwan, this is the point that we are making, that you see that these people who are claiming to rectify Islam and the Muslims and the Sunnah, they are doing no such thing. Don't fall for their slogans. Don't fall for their empty slogans and sentiments, because what they are doing is perpetuating the humiliation that is upon the Muslims, because they are spreading the very deviations that led to the demise of the Ummah in the first place. Allahu Akbar.